The new version of Final Cut Pro for iPad finally dropped, and in this video, I'm gonna give you my honest thoughts about these big updates. Let's just dive right in. The first big exciting update is that Final Cut Pro for iPad 2 now supports external storage. You don't have to store all your media on your iPad. Obviously, this isn't a surprise. They talked about this during the Apple event, but it truly is a game changer, and it's going to make the app a lot more usable for a lot more people. So I thought I should mention it first, because in my opinion, it's really like the one update that the Final Cut Pro for iPad app really needed. Now let's talk about the feature everyone's been buzzing about, live multicam. With live multicam, you can sync up to 4 devices to your Final Cut Pro for iPad app and record directly into your iPad. A few things to know here. This only works with mobile Apple devices like your iPhone or your iPad. You can't use this feature with another camera. Also, all of your devices need to have Final Cut Camera installed on them. That's a free app in the App Store, also dropping today. If you want to know more about the Final Cut Camera app, I did just post a full tutorial on it on my main channel that I will link to right here. But the one big thing I want to call your attention to is that if you have an iPhone 15, you can now shoot log in 4K, which we weren't able to do before. So once you've got the camera app installed, and your Bluetooth and Wi-Fi enabled, you're just gonna sync everything up to your master iPad. Now, I am gonna be posting a step-by-step tutorial on the multicam workflow in the Final Cut Pro for iPad app very shortly. So I'm just gonna run through the steps with you here, but I'm not gonna get into all the details. So once we had all of our devices connected, we set one phone on a tripod, another one overhead on a C-stand, and we had two operators running the iPads. And then as the director, I was using my M4 iPad as the monitor for all of these cameras. So once we started the shoot, not only could I see what every camera was seeing, I could actually control the settings of that camera. I could control the zoom of that camera, and I could start and stop record all remotely. So the camera ops didn't have to do anything but point the lens at the action. Once we were done with the shoot, I just hit done, and automatically all of those files started populating inside my Final Cut Pro for iPad app as multicam clips. But it's important for you to know that these files are just proxies. You still need to transfer that media from every other recording device into your iPad. Once you start the transfer, you can see the progress wheels on each of these clips. But you can actually start editing with these files even before the transfer is over because you do have those proxies. You can still do multicam editing in the Final Cut Pro for iPad app, even if you didn't use this live multicam workflow. If you shot your media on different devices, you would just import them like you normally do, create the multicam clips just like you would in the Mac app, and edit in the same way. I will also be covering that workflow in my multicam tutorial. Once you're ready to edit, you can just drop your multicam clip into your timeline and then hit this button, multicam, to open up your angle viewer. You can select which angle you want to pull audio from. So I'm always going to be taking audio from the overhead shot, and then just play your timeline and hit each of these windows to switch between your different angles. If you have the magic keyboard, you can also hit the 1, 2, 3, and 4 keys to switch between those angles too. So what do I think about this live multicam workflow? Once I got all my devices connected to my iPad, it worked great. One thing that tripped me up was that a lot of my old devices had the same name as my current devices, because when I replace, let's say, my phone, I never go into the settings and rename it. And for the live multicam function to work, all of your devices need to have unique names. So you just need to go into your device settings and rename your device so that the iPad app didn't get confused. I loved that I could control all of the settings on all of my cameras right from the iPad. This was especially useful for that overhead shot on the C-stand. The functionality of this is really great. And I love that my proxies were in my project immediately, so I could get editing even though my real files were still transferring. Some of the weak spots for live cam multicam, I would say, are that all of your recording devices have to either be iPhones or iPads. No support for other types of cameras, which is kind of a bummer because that means that your picture quality is only going to be as good as your oldest device. And like in my professional office, I for sure have 4 4K cameras that I can shoot log, but I don't have 4 iPhone 15s. And so for one of these angles, I used my old iPad, which doesn't even shoot in 4K. And I definitely think you can see the difference. And maybe you can scrounge together a few friends who all have iPhone 15s that you can borrow. Just keep in mind that while that transfer is happening after your shoot, those phones need to stay in close proximity to your iPad for the transfer to be complete. They cannot run off with them. Another drawback I found was during the multicam editing process. If you want to apply an effect or a color correction or a transform to a particular angle in your project, it's a little bit tricky. So if you want to edit your angles, you want to make sure you're opened up on the multicam window and then select edit angles. Now in this window, you can apply color corrections and effects and use the transform tools in this angle editor. And if you wanted to color correct, let's say the entire duration of a particular angle, you would do that in this window, just like you would on the Final Cut Pro Mac app. But this I think is a little tricky. Your inclination, I think, would be to click on this preview window to, let's say, apply a color correction, but nothing happens when you click on that. You actually need to click on the audio waveforms in order to apply a color correction. It's pretty counterintuitive. So let's say I wanted to apply color adjustments. I can make adjustments to that clip here, right in this window, but the challenge I have is that you cannot expand the preview window to be any bigger than it is, and there's no scopes in this view either. So it's not really a good workflow. Let me show you the workaround. I'm going to delete those color adjustments. I'm gonna hit done to exit out of here. Find that clip I wanted to color correct in my angle editor, but I have to find it here in my main timeline. And then I could make all of my color adjustments in this view with my scopes. And then copy this effect, go back to the angle editor, and paste that color adjustment. And then exit out of that and disable the color adjustment on my timeline so it's not duplicated. Such a clunky workflow, in my opinion. In addition to this new external drive support and this new multicam workflow, Final Cut Pro for iPad 2 got some new soundtracks, some new title templates, some new color board presets, and some new backgrounds. And while Final Cut Pro for iPad 2 obviously got big upgrades, there's still a few things that I think are missing. For instance, the color correction tools for me are still totally insufficient, especially given the fact that Apple just dropped this sick M4 iPad with this tandem OLED screen. This should be the perfect device for color correcting, but you don't have the tools in the Final Cut Pro for iPad app to really do it, and I'm definitely missing them. We've also not heard a peep about third-party plugin support, and it's still a one-way workflow from Final Cut Pro for iPad to the Mac app. So I can take this project from Final Cut Pro for iPad and bring it to the Mac app, but I cannot take a Mac app project and bring it to my iPad. And I would love to see the ability to do that. I think that workflow would be super useful for a creator like myself. So I'm hoping to see that in the near future. Do any of these updates make you super excited about the Final Cut Pro for iPad app? Let me know in the comments if you're going to be hopping on this app soon. If you want more information about the multicam workflow, stay tuned for that video. It's coming very, very soon. Thanks for hanging out, you guys. Thanks to everyone who watches all the way to the end. I'll see you again.